let's create this game. First, let's upload the backdrop. We will delete the cat and upload the first costume for the hammer. So we will change the name to hammer. And it's big, let's change its size to 50. Okay, so looks okay. Then we'll upload the first costume for the mole. It's also big, let's change it to size to 60. I'll change the name to mole. So we have hammer and mole, but each of them has only one costume. So let's choose mole and click costume, upload the other two costumes, mole 2 and mole 3. And go to hammer, upload the second costume for the hammer, hammer 2. Okay, now let's look at the code. So the mole will pop up from the holes and will use the hammer to knock his head. The mole will go into the hole. Okay, so let's look at the code for hammer first. How does the hammer move? It will follow our mouse. So we go to invents. When green flag clicked, it will always follow our mouse. So we will have a forever loop. And go to motion. The hammer will always go to mouse pointer. So if you try, see, whenever our mouse goes, the hammer will follow it. Okay. So the other thing is that the hammer has two costumes, lift up and knock down. So let's do another. When green flag clicked, this is also a forever loop. When we press down the mouse, the hammer will knock down. Okay, so if you come to sensing, there is something called mouse done. If mouse done, then I will choose the second costume. So go to looks, switch costume to hammer 2. But once you knock down, after that you need to lift up. Go to control, wait for 0.5 seconds. Then I will switch the costume back to costume 1. So we change the costume, but then think about it. At the start of the game, the hammer should be lifted up. So before the forever loop, we will do change costume to hammer 1. Okay, so it will lift up first. Every time you press down the mouse, it will go down. So that's the code for the hammer. Now let's look at the mole. The mole will randomly appear in one of these three holes. So whenever it appears, we will move the mouse, also the hammer, to above the mole, then we will knock the head, the mole will go into the hole. So we go to events. When green flag clicked, since this is a game, we want to keep track of our score. So go to variables. Make a variable, I'll just call it score. Click OK. And we need another variable to keep track which hole the mole selects. So we'll make another variable called choice. This is the hole that the mole will appear. So let's just make this is choice 1, choice 2, choice 3. Once we create these two variables, you can see they are displayed here. I want to display the score, but I don't want to display the choice, right? I don't want the player to know which hole the mole is appearing. So we just uncheck this box. Then the choice will disappear from the screen. We only have the score. Now let's look at the code for the mole. When green flag clicks, the mole will appear in different holes. But before the game starts, we need to set the score to 0. Go to variables, set score to 0. Then we will have a forever loop for the mole to appear. When the game starts, the mole shouldn't be visible. So we will hide the mole first. And we want to make sure it always starts from the first costume. So we are set. Switch costume, to move on. Then we're going to pick one of the holes randomly. So go to variables, set, choice, which is which hole. Let's say this is hole 1, 2, 3. I want to pick it randomly, so go to operations, pick a random number from 1, 2, 3, because we only have 3 holes. Now go to control. If choice equal to 1, so go to variables, choice. If choice equal to 1, I want the mode to appear in this hole. Okay, let's go to costume, choose the first costume. So I want it to be here. Look at the position, it's minus 150 and 45. So go to motion. Glide 1 second to minus 150 and 45. And similarly, if choice equal to 2, equal to 3, we'll do the same. So I will get this out. I'll choose duplicate. Duplicate again. Okay, so we have 3 copies. This is choice equal to 1. If choice equal to 2, let's look at the position. Okay, let's make it easier. So minus 5, minus 75. Minus 75. Okay, this is when choice equal to 2. Put it after first if. Now what if choice equal to 3? Okay, so let's make it 1, 2, 0. This will make it 10. Still looks okay. So it's 1, 2, 0. And 10, it will appear. And remember, we hide the mole. So once we choose the hole, we need to show the mole. So let's show it. Once the mole appears, the player will move the hammer over. So we need to check whether the hammer touched the mole. If it touched the mole will go back into the hole. Let's wait for 1 second. Then we will check. How to check? We will use if. If the mole touch the hammer, and the other thing we need to make sure is the hammer is knocking down. If the hammer is lifting it up, you can't let the mole disappear. So we need 2 conditions. I'll go to operations. And so first condition is the mole touch the hammer. Second condition is the hammer is knocking down. So for first condition, go to sensing. If it's touching the hammer. And second condition is the hammer is knocking down. How do you tell the hammer is knocking down? Check the costume. When it's costume, is costume number 2. So let's go back to the code. Click the mole. Second condition is go to operations. When the costume number of the hammer equals to 2. So how do we get the costume number of the hammer? So go to sensing and drag out this. Okay, so of the hammer. And this should be costume number. With costume number of hammer equal to 2, that means the hammer is hacking down and it's touching the mole, so the mole should go back to the hole. And how does the mole go back? First, it will change the costume, and then the other thing we need to do is the mole will move downwards. Okay, so let's do this. First, go to looks, switch costume to mole 2. And we move down a little bit. So go to motion, change Y, move down maybe minus 15. So you can test different numbers, see which one works best. I've tested, this one should be minus 15. Then I will switch costume to mode 3, I'll change Y again. And I have tested, this time it works best to change Y by minus 10. After that, we need to change the score. So let's add a small weight. Let's add weight for a little bit of time, like 0.1. And we're going to variables. We're going to change score by 1. So now let's try. Okay, see, something we need to do is like the hammer appears behind the mole, which doesn't make sense. So what we can do, let's stop this, go to the hammer, and go to looks, we do this, go to front layer. So the hammer should appear in the front layer rather than behind the mole. Okay, so let's try again. You can see the mole goes down, and every time the hammer knocks the mole, our score is increased by 1. That's all for Whack-a-Mole. Subscribe to our channel to watch more tutorials. See you next time!